What's up, guys? Today, what we're going to do is we're going to look at setting up our science interactive notebook. To let you guys know, the notebook is going to be similar to what you guys did in sixth grade and seventh grade. And for those of you who are new, the steps should help you kind of set it up. The first thing I want you to do is I want you to set up your front cover kind of similar to what I have right here in the on my example, on my slide that I have. I want a title for your notebook. I want your name, the class name, teacher's name, and then the year. The main reason I want all that is so that if it gets lost, it'll be easy for me to get it back to you or some other teacher to return it to me. After you get that set up, the next thing you're going to do is you're going to go to your table of contents. With your table of contents, it's going to be your very first page. You'll have a different table of contents for each semester. With these table of contents, what you're going to do is the very first thing is on the very first page, you're going to put across the top, table of contents. After you write table of contents, underneath it, you'll see that I have something already labeled for you. It's going to be process skills, which is an introduction to our unit. And then we'll have the very first thing that we'll do in class, which is our helicopter lab. And you'll see I have the date there along with a page number. With your table of contents, like I said, the very first thing on the very top page, I want you to write table of contents out. And then underneath that, write process skills. That process skills is opening the unit, and it's going to be a title page that I'll talk about in just a minute. That opens up to that new unit. So every unit that we have, you'll have a specific title page. With those title pages, you do not need a date and you do not need a page number. After you put that title page, you're going to start putting a bunch of things that relate inside your notebook that relate to that specific unit. So for example, the very first thing that you're going to do after you write down process skills is you're going to next write down helicopter lab. This is a lab that ties into process skills. This lab is going to be on the 27th, so you should have the date down, and then your page number. It's going to be on page 1. I'm not sure if it's going to go to page 4 or not. It kind of depends on how you write, so you always want to kind of save your, to write in your page numbers till you're done with the lab. For me, it might be pages 1 through 4. For you, it might be pages 1 through 7, so our page numbers will not match, but our dates will always match. Make sure whenever you're doing a lab, investigation, notes, whatever it might be that goes in this notebook, there's a date and a page number. The only things that don't need a date and a page number are going to be your title pages. All right, so next, you will have a title page. For your title page, for example, the process skills one, the very first one that you do, you want to write out process skills somewhere on one page of paper in your notebook, and then you're going to want to add color to that title page. With color, I also want some pictures. I want at least two pictures that relate to that unit. So for example, for this first thing with process skills talk about, like, you know, things of steps of scientific method, conclusions, hypothesis, independent, dependent variables, those types of things. So maybe you could put, you know, a picture of a different, of an investigation and label the independent variable with it. Whatever it might be that relates to that unit, those are the pictures that I'll be looking for. I want the pictures to have color and I want them to be neat. I do not want you to print them off of a computer and then glue them in your notebook, because then it starts getting a little bit sloppy. I want you to hand draw them. If you're not an artist, no big deal. Just try your best. That's all I can ask. So every title page will have at least two pictures, and it needs to be colorful. And they need to be hand-drawn pictures. And it'll take up just one page. And those pictures, of course, have to relate to that title of that unit. So the first one that you'll do will be process skills. Here's some examples of some title pages. You know, maybe they were doing an astronomy lesson and they did something with moon phases and they're showing that the moon reflects light. Or maybe we had something with the layers of the earth and they had the asthenosphere, mantle, whatever, all that stuff labeled for that specific unit. So you can do something like that. You know, if I look at that moon phase one, there's like three or four different drawings in there. So that definitely counts as two. If I look at that earth one, there's a couple different drawings in there. Those definitely count as two. So the more detail you make it, the better it's going to be. And it's nice, it's neat, it's colorful, so it works great. And it's also labeled. It's important to label your drawings. As we go through with your investigations, for example, the helicopter lab, which is going to be the very first thing that we do, every investigation that you do, notes, investigation, lab, whatever it might be, needs to have a title, a date, and a page number. And you'll see that the title is going to be at the very top of the page. Your title needs to match my title, unless it's an investigation that you are creating. And then you'll have a page number on there, and you'll have your page numbers in the bottom right-hand corner of your title page. With this, with these investigations, what you should include in there should be graphs when needed. So if you're doing some sort of comparative or experimental investigation, you need a graph, I expect it to be in there. Notes, research, conclusions, analysis of your graphs or of your data tables, whatever it might be, Your data tables, assignments, anything that we do in class should be in your notebook. This is almost going to serve as your textbook. Everything that we test you on is going to come from that notebook. Here are some examples of what that might look like. Here are some notes over here. You can see the different types of matter. We have a gas, we have liquids, and we have solids. We have natural resources over here. There's great drawings. They're labeled. They're colorful. It's very important that it's as neat as possible so you can go back and you can actually know what the heck you're talking about when you're studying. You can shorthand stuff in your notebook. That's no problem. But make sure it's something that you understand when you do it. If it's an investigation, if it's a you know, some sort of big piece of a lab, then you might want to cut out that shorthand and maybe add more detail to it. Shorthand maybe will fall more into notes or labeling diagrams. For your notes, like I said, we'll have notes in class. We won't have a ton of notes that you'll sit and watch me lecture or anything like that, but we will have some notes that you'll take. These notes could be off of a reading or something that you research. That stuff needs to be in your notebook as well. I like it being highlighted. I like it being underlined. I like you to annotate it so you know exactly what's going on with those notes that you take. What is it, if you're taking notes on food webs, you know, what are those little, what do the arrows stand for? I don't know, something like that that you can annotate on the outside of your notes. You can include diagrams and pictures so that one day, like I said, you can go back and study it and hopefully help you understand that that content or that topic. And then just a couple rules with your notebook. You can see them all right here, and these rules are probably going to be the same rules that you've had for every single one of your teachers. Make sure you keep it neat. I understand notebooks rip and they tear. Just do your best to keep it neat. If it falls apart, then once again, you're not going to be able to look at it to study and go over the material that you need to be successful. I want your science notebook to be your science notebook. I do not want you know, history class or mathematics or language arts classes, that information, your art class, that stuff in your science notebook. That should be in another notebook itself. I want your science notebook to pertain to the science class, which will definitely include art, language arts, and math and history, but I don't want your stuff from other classes involved with mine with our notebook. Everything must go in the table of contents. Kind of said that already. Be colorful. If it's colorful, it just kind of pops to the eye and it stands out to you a little bit more. I'm not saying you have to go in there and color every single thing, but just make it nice. And big thing is, if you forget your notebook or you are absent, then it is your responsibility to make sure and make up whatever you miss. It's your responsibility. You come to the teacher and say, hey, when can I make up what I missed? If you get with friends, you can also go to them and say, hey, you know, I missed this lab. Can I see what you put in there? That's fine, but you still need to go back in and make up whatever you missed. Lastly, you have notebook grading. Your notebook grading is going to be the same as probably what you did in 6th and 7th grade. It's going to be an application assessment grade, meaning it's a 60% grade. So it's one of your major grades that you have for the school 6 weeks. With the notebook, how I'm going to grade it is we're going to give you some sort of assessment that is over the entire 6 weeks of that notebook. So if we do the helicopter lab, some sort of you know, Alka-Seltzer lab, or some sort of other labs that we'll do for this first unit, I will for the first 6 weeks, I will test you over everything that's in your notebook. You'll be able to use your notebook when you take this assessment and apply whatever you've learned from with your notebook to that assessment so that, of course, you can get that great grade that you deserve or want. It'll be graded every 6 weeks, so every 6 weeks you'll have some sort of notebook assessment. And like I said, for that notebook assessment, you'll be able to use your notebook, so it's open notebook test. But you have to have your notebook, and it has to be complete for it to be valuable. If you don't have your notebook, then you're not going to perform well, and that grade, of course, is going to bring down your overall grade because a 60% grade is a big chunk of your overall grade. That's pretty much it for your notebook. That's kind of like an overview of how to set it up. If you guys have any questions, feel free to ask Mr. Perez, myself, Ms. Axe, about how to set up your notebook. We'll be going through different steps of what you need to have in your notebook and things like that throughout the year. We will always have our table of contents on our boards, and you'll see exactly the dates that we did a lab. You'll see the titles of the lab, so everything will kind of be there to help keep you organized with your notebook. If you have any questions, feel free to shoot us an email or bring them to class, and then we can discuss it when you get here. Thanks, guys, for listening, and we'll see you guys tomorrow.